Mark, and this is Hannah, my guitar. Hannah is a secure Japanese guitar. Now at the moment, I have this capo on it, or capo, on it, the second fret, and the reason why is the tuning I normally use is this. Open D, drop D tuning thing, and I kind of like it because I like it. It's mellow, it's low, and it drops the chord down. And you've got a deep voice, it's good to sing along with. So to bring it back up to normal chromatic tuning, that's why that's there. So now we know. It's an E minor. So let's work this out. If I use the E minor, E minor 7, an E minor, another E minor 7, goes nicely. See, when you lift off my fingers, put them back on like a hammer off it. I like that because it adds a little bit of flavour. And also, I was using another skin. Vibrato. Vibrato is nice, it gives a bit more colour. It stretches that chord out. So let's add some chords to this. Remember last time I did with cards? These cards. So that's where I've got my E minor. E minor 7. A minor. E minor 7. And see them. These cards come in a box. Like this. Now there's a description or link down below. There should be one on here and the previous videos I've done. And also on the next video that's up. So the other version was let's add some more chords. So I went previously I had let's get it right round B7 sort of trick F and C sharp 9. Now I found that kind of works kind of. But by adding a C7 and a C brings it a bit more in. And then I thought at some point one of the earlier cards I pulled up was this, was a 7th flat with a 7th with a flat 5th. So I thought, I wonder if I add those together, how it sounds. So I'll go into that a bit more in the next video. But let's have a look at that chord, shall we? So we've got one finger down here on the second fret with the first finger on the second string. And we take our middle finger. No, not like that, like that. And we stick that on the string. Now, we work this down, you see that that's a G note. This one, meaning ring finger, goes two strings down in the same fret. And the pinky is the next string down on the next fret. So it's kind of a pretty jazzy chord, isn't it? G's come like this, and I've got the normal finger there on the E there, and then I've got my finger on the G there, then I've got my finger down here, one there on the pinky on the tiny string, and then one on the string above it in the third, and then a G up there, and then to move to that C9 thing that a lot of people use. Because all I can do is move my top fingers down. If I take my pinky off, C. Sound different, doesn't it? We're going to that.